This here is the Annie Pro 2, which came out a little over 3 years ago, but does it still hold up in 2022? Let's find out. The unboxing experience was quite good, with a subtle white box with some branding on the front, and sides with a picture of the keyboard and its white option. On the back of the box is some info on the keyboard, with the keyboard in black. Opening the box, you see the keyboard front and center, in a box enclosure wrapped in foam. On the underneath of the keyboard, you get the instructions, and underneath the box, you get extra colored keygaps, a Type-C cable, and a keycap puller. Connecting the keyboard was easy. Just press the FN plus 1 key to activate Bluetooth mode, then connect via Bluetooth settings. The keyboard also allows you to connect via the included Type-C cable as well. It packs in a 1900 mAh battery, which lasts about 8 hours when in constant use, but should last about a week on regular usage. The Annie Pro 2 is a 60% keyboard and comes in two colors as discussed, white and black, which is the one I have here. They can also be purchased with Cherry, Gateron or Kali switches. I got the Gateron browns, which feel amazing, which I will touch on later. Also, just keep in mind that the Annie Pro 2 is not hot swappable. The keyboard also has a slant with 4 rubber feet on the bottom to keep it from sliding around. The Annie Pro 2 is also on the lighter side, at around 1.4 pounds or 635 grams. The keycaps have a normal font style instead of going for that gaming font style that a lot of keyboards opt for, like the K552 that I did a review on. They are also made from double shot PBT, which means they won't be developing a nasty shine in time. Of course, these can be changed to anything with Cherry MX stems or the included extra keycaps. The Gateron brown switches that I got feel good and smooth. They come with stabilizers to prevent wobble and have a light 55 gram actuation force, which is good for quick actuation. The Annie Pro 2 comes with a wide selection of color effects to choose from, all of which can be changed by pressing the function and 9 keys. You can also use the Oben software to change and control the lighting. The software also allows you to change the brightness and assign macros. You can also press the function key and press one of the function buttons, which can also be customized in the software. Even though this keyboard is a little over 3 years old, it still holds up incredibly well in 2022. With its PBT keycaps, very good build quality, great lighting effects and excellent switches, all for around $100 Australian. I'll drop links to the keyboard down below so you can pick one up. As always, don't forget to subscribe, drop a like, and see you guys next time.